Hi, it's Bill Parsons from Nine Life Solutions, and I'm here today talking with Joe from RTA in Dayton, and we're going to talk about the Roadworthy Communications Program. Joe, you have had, as a trainer for RTA, you've had the opportunity to basically sit through the Roadworthy Communication training multiple times. So each time you sit through it, tell me, do you walk away with something different from it, or does it just reinforce the skills you already got, or what's your take on it?
A combination of both of those two things. There's so much good information packed in there that you do walk away with new ideas and new practical applications every class.
So, I mean, let me ask you this. For you, and you mentioned the word practical. Would you say that the techniques we discuss in the training are actually practical, street-worthy, stuff that your operators can apply when they walk out of here? Because, I mean, one of my goals is to, I don't want this to be academic. I don't want them to walk out going, this is great theory. I want them to have real tools. Would you say that is the case? They have some real tools they can walk out and apply?
Absolutely. They're equipped with real tools that are backed with, I would say, decades of research in social science. And you're able to package that into a format that is practical. For example, it's not what they what you say, it's what they hear.
Right, one of the core principles we talk about.
Absolutely. Soften, I think, in the transit scenario is perfect.
Okay.
And that what that does, like you've taught us, it enables us to move from transactional to
to connective.
Connective. And
sure.
So you've got that 10 to 20 seconds there at the fare box where you can lean in, you give eye contact, you speak softly and friendly to someone, and it enables them to feel comfortable and do your job at a level that prior to receiving this training, you wouldn't have been able to do.
Do you have a specific incident or story or multiple stories even that where you have used some of the techniques and you've seen them been effective for you, either in your personal life or even or here at RTA?
Well, one of the stories that I like to tell, in the beginning of this training day, what we'll do is you'll have your four-hour block of Roadworthy Communications, and then I do 4 hours of continuing education.
Right.
And so I like to tell a story. My son's 8 years old, and he absolutely does not want to brush his teeth. And so that's a battle often.
Sure.
And so finally I'd had it one night, and I said, Cameron, you are acting like a brat. I'm tired of it. And what's he say? Dad, I'm not a brat. He heard me say, Cameron, you're a brat.
Right.
But what I really said was, you're acting like a brat. So that is a textbook example of, it's not what you say, it's what they hear.
Right.
And so, and I had known that prior to this class, but I didn't have a label on it in my mind. I didn't understand it. What this class did for me was it gave me the ability to recognize that.
Right,
and
so
therefore take the steps, right, the corrective steps through the class and able to work around those things or fix those things.
You know, and a lot of times it's our expectations of people is how they behave. If they know, if we call them a name or they see that we think they're going to behave a certain way, they live up to or down to our expectations of their behavior. So that's an excellent example of that. So of those skills, soften is one of the ones you tend to use the most.
Absolutely.
And then the core principle of it's not what you say, it's what they hear.
Yes.
Now, you are a trainer here at RTA, and you drive a bus. I mean,
that's
you're an
correct.
Operator every day. So you're a boots-on-the-ground guy. You get to interact with your customers every day and the other operators every day. What kind of stuff do you hear from the other operators, you know, when they, you know, coming into training, what's their expectation, then coming out of training, what are they saying?
Coming into training, you know, the expectations are truly across the board. Leaving out, the overwhelming majority of the people truly gain benefit from it and are appreciative of the skills and the techniques that they learn, not only because of how many skills were discussed, but the depth of those skills. The ability to walk away with a manual, we'll call it,
right,
and continue. You know, you can go in as deep into these principles as you want to.
Oh, absolutely.
And one of the things that I love that you said, that you have said, is that anybody can become an artist. love that. And so, you know, a lot of the times guys and girls walk into the classroom, they say, hey, I'm just a bus driver.
Correct, right.
You know what? Come on.
Right.
But you walk out of the class and you go, wow, you know what? This, I have some motivation here.
Right.
And I can make this an art form.
Exactly. And see, and when we think of art, we tend to think of a painting on the wall or a picture. And art truly, it lives and breathes, and we can do it in any environment that we're in. And I think when we create art, whether it's as a bus operator or a police officer or a window washer, like I say in class, you know, we are doing our very best, mm-hmm. you know, and it makes us a little vulnerable when we do that, but we also know we're serving in a way that makes a difference. And I'm glad that kind of principle actually touched you, because
yes,
I think art is what is going to save us. I mean, if we walk in thinking we're just technicians, when in reality we're all artists at whatever it is we do, and we can elevate it to that level.
Yes.
So that's great. I'm glad that principle impacted. Okay, so overall, to kind of sum things up, would you say that the roadworthy communication trainings that we've done here would be something that everybody in the transit industry should be doing, and why would you say that? I mean, what?
Very beneficial, because it's so useful and practical. And I would recommend this course to any street supervisor, any bus driver, any agency where their employees are dealing, where they're dealing with the public.
In a direct manner, like
in
they're directly
direct
dealing
manner,
with their customer.
Face-to-face, as you like to say, boots on the ground.
Right. Now, let me ask you this. From an interpersonal, inside the organization, dealing with, you know, management, your other bus drivers, other employees you work with every day, can these skills be used to improve those relationships?
Certainly they could be.
Okay.
And it's just a matter of applying them. Referring back to the manual and keeping them fresh in your mind.
Right, because like we've talked about, that the natural tendency to communicate is not most of the time all that effective, so we got to kind of fall back on some skills that we have to learn and practice.
And that's the challenge of it, and that's the beauty of it. You have to apply yourself to this, and anything that is worth going after...
You put your effort into, sure.
Absolutely.
It's like we just talked about art a little bit. I mean, you can take communications, anything, to the level of art and say, you know what, I'm going to do this even better next time. Even though that went
absolutely.
Well, I'm going to do it better next time. And like I talk about, when we talk about in the class, you know, the unexamined life is not worth living. So sometimes you step back and go, you know what, I'm doing this a lot better. How can I even do it better again?
I
think that's sort of what you're talking about is, you know, if it's worth doing, it's worth doing well.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And create good art.